really cannot OD on pace unless you don't show up for work because you're doing pace all morning. So take a sip of water and one hand on the belly button, the other hand makes a C. Bring it to where the collarbones and the breastbone intersect. Now, I'm going to embellish this a little, but if you're someone who's prone to headaches or dizziness or vertigo, I want you just to keep your head still and your eyes still. If not, take your eyes horizontally, keeping your head still, and yes, this will be harder than you might first imagine. So you're just rubbing the sternoclavicular joints and switch hands. And going into this movement. And you may find you can only scan horizontally for a few, and then you have to bring the eyes back to the center. And then into the cross crawl, wrist to opposite thigh. Now, watch out for speed racing. I always tease people that I'm gonna write a ticket because they come in and they're doing their cross crawl like this, right? That's not what this is about. So I try to have them slow it down. Now, if you want to get fancy tonight, you can turn your cross crawl. I take people, you don't have to, I take people through spinning balances. And just feeling this opportunity to explore your space a little more. Yeah. And then into the hookup again, cross one leg over, bring the arms in front like you're going to clap but miss. Turn your palms to face one another, interlace the fingers, bring them in. Relax your shoulders. Now, if you can, put the tongue on the roof of the mouth. Stay there and hold this, but I want to show you. Let's say you're at one of those 3-hour-long endurance meetings. How can you do this without drawing attention to the fact? I mean, I do this all the time on planes. I really don't care. But you could be in a meeting, and this is your cross crawl. I don't know if you saw me sitting like this when you came in. So it's like I'm just, or excuse me, not cross crawl, your hookup. Because I just want to keep that connected energy. And we'll talk more about what a hookup is at the end. So there are all sorts of ways. You could be like this, lying down. I love the hookup right before bed, but I wouldn't do the whole pace sequence right before bed because it can increase your energy. Now, phase two of the hookup on cross, come here or here. I had a woman in a few weeks ago who was very distraught because she had forgotten to do phase two. Don't worry about it. She got phase one. It's great. I empower people to do this, and I expect them to do it as soon as they get in the door before we start. And if they don't, then we have to do it together. So this is just how everyone, no matter what they're doing or what their healing process is, will start. All right, so now we're going to go into one of my favorite parts of this work. It's called noticing. And I truly think it is a gift. So I'm going to have you sit down for a moment and have your pen and paper close by. And now close your eyes and scan your body. So scan head to toe, everything that you can, and notice what's drawing you in. Tension, discomfort, concern. Notice that area, and if you can reach it without doing acrobatics tonight, put your hand on it. So if you can't reach it, just imagine you're touching it. Now give this spot a color. Go with what bubbles up first. And give this spot a number. There's no scale like 0 to 10. Whatever comes up. Next, give this spot a texture. Is it smooth like silk? Is it coarse like sandpaper? Next, what sensation resides here? Is it taut? Is it burning? And lastly, what emotion is here? Is there frustration? Is there fear? So once you have clarity around those, and I'll list them out again, I'd like you to write them down on your sheet of paper. That tactile input of writing is really important. So you had a color, you had a number. Color, number, texture. Sensation. Is it taut? Is it burning? Ooh, school supplies coming in right now.
Does anyone need a pencil or more? Or
and lastly, I think we need some over So lastly, what emotion? What emotion is there? And remember not to judge this. We're really good at moving away from judging others, but aren't we so quick to judge ourselves? Just go with what bubbles up. You do not need to turn this in at the end. You can rip it up and leave it in the trash can if you wish. So you had a color, a number, a texture, a sensation, and an emotion. All right? Now, I ask you, if this area could serve you better, and I am certain that it can, how would you like this area to feel instead? So, for example, earlier today I was doing this on myself, and I said, it was just a little right sacral talking to me, and I said, I am flexible, strong, and stable.